And we are back for the final game of today's stream, World Cup of VGC Pokemon. I am Costa, and joined once again for a final time today with Mr. Jamie Boy himself. And we've got a rocking cracker of a final match for you today. Israel versus Portugal, Jamie.
So we've seen some great games already. Hoping to see one final great game between these two players. We're going to be having Kobe Weiss versus Diogo Henriquez for both Israel and Portugal here. So we can see how Israel and Portugal have been doing so far in this first round of the World Cup. And it seems like Israel have a slight lead there with that 2-1 advantage.
Yeah, they definitely have, as we've seen. Dov, the manager of Israel, versus Nuno Rosario, 2-1 win right there. With that Tornoda team there, with the Tarina and a Ditto, actually, not a Shedinja of what you would have expected from that team composition. We've got a Raikou on Aminadav's side there. Very interesting pick there. Once again, rocking the Tornoda set, but unfortunately lost against Francisco's... oh my lord, is that actually an Eternatus?
It seems like there's two of them at least for Portugal.
Wow.
Coming out from Pedro's side of the field as well. Very similar teams, but only one of them being able to get that victory there. The Xerneas from Shy coming out and defeating that Eternatus. So Israel's in the slight advantage here, and we'll have to see if Kobe is able to push that advantage here. So we'll be able to see what teams they're both going to be running, going to be starting with Kobe, and seeing that he is going to be running that Solgaleo as well.
Wow, Solgaleo, Mien Shao, Rillaboom, Tornadus Incarnate, Galarian, Moltres, and that Raikou.
Yeah, a very, very cool team coming out from Kobe here. Solgaleo is not a Pokemon you see too often as a restricted. With the Steel typing, you'd almost certainly see that Zacian instead. But Solgaleo does have some nice things that Zacian does not. It can't be intimidated thanks to its full metal body. It does have access to stuff like Wide Guard and Trick Room, which are very crucial moves going into this format as well. So a very, very cool pick coming out from the Solgaleo there for Kobe.
Yeah, there's a lot of variety when it comes to Solgaleo as well. Definitely has more coverage and access to move pools than you would expect, thanks to that psychic typing too. But we're going to go ahead and go check out the player profile of their opponent, which is going to be Diogo Henriquez representing Portugal and actually rocking an Yveltal, Comfey, Landorus Incarnate, Torkoal, Stat Attacker, and the Amoongus. The team feels like there's got different parts to it that I just don't expect to synergize as much.
Yeah, there's some very cool Pokemon coming out from both players here. The Comfey, usually indicative of a weakness policy on the Yveltal. You do want to be going for that Draining Kiss into your own Yveltal to be able to do some huge damage here. So we'll have to see if that is the option of choice that Diogo has gone for this Yveltal. But immediately, an Yveltal against a Solgaleo is what you want to be seeing if you are Diogo. So it's going to be a very interesting matchup to see if Kobe can respond to that Yveltal.
Yeah, as what we are going to be doing is we're going to be bringing the action straight to your screens right now. And of course, we are going to be seeing it from Kobe's side of the field. Very, very interesting matchup here. You've got the Yveltal versus Solgaleo. Naturally, type-wise, Yveltal does have the advantage. But there are other Pokemon to take into consideration, like that Raikou, which could potentially even put on some sort of pressure against this Yveltal.
Yeah, the Raikou would definitely be the best way through the Yveltal for Kobe's side of the field here, as we are going to be seeing it from Kobe's perspective. And yeah, you do need to be taking out that Yveltal to free up your Solgaleo there. Something like the Mind Shell could be pretty good as well if the Yveltal's going to be carrying Assault Vest instead of the Weakness Policy. That'll be able to do some good physical damage to bypass that as well. And you can deal with the Stack Attacker pretty well with the Mind Shell as well, but Solgaleo can take on Stack Attacker pretty well. You also need to be concerned of the Landorus as well. Landorus is still going to have a really good matchup into the Solgaleo as well, and there's not an immediate obvious answer to that Landorus as well. You've got the Raikou that's very, very good against Yveltal, but what's going to be very good against this Landorus here?
I guess Raikou can learn. I think it might be Scald, but I'm not sure if it might be rocking it in this scenario. Maybe it could be a sneak peek, who knows? As we are going to be going into game one between Israel versus Portugal, their first streamed match of this tournament. We're going to be seeing over on Diogo's side the Amoongus and Comfey, very passive lead, maybe trying to guarantee that trick room there, as we do see Kobe bringing the Tornadus Incarnate as well as the Galarian Moltres.
Yeah, usually when you lead a Pokemon like this with the redirection and potential trick room, that does indicate that's what you're going to be going for, because you're not going to be doing too much damage with the Amoongus or the Comfey. You can start spreading those spores if you wanted with the Amoongus as you set up the trick room, but in the face of a Tornadus that could be carrying Taunt as well, or just going on the offensive, you've got two flying types staring down that Amoongus as well. But you do need to be careful. If the option of going for trick room is what Diogo wants to go for, you need to be careful of knocking out Pokemon to give a free switch in, but not going to be knocking out that Amoongus as it has gone for a protector.
Ooh, so maybe try, oh wow, a double up as well from both the Tornadus and the Moltres, just allowing Diogo to go for the very, very ever so free trick room setup. And now Diogo does have that pressure, passive pressure of the Spore.
Yeah, that was a very, very strong turn from Diogo there, getting the trick room up completely for free. There was nothing coming out from Kobe's side of the field. At least you get to see that it's Air Slash on the Tornadus instead of Hurricane at this point. But now, yeah, the Amoongus, if it doesn't get taunted from the Tornadus, it's going to be able to spoil whatever Pokemon it wants. And so we'll have to see if that's what's going to be coming out here. Draining Kiss into Moltres is a very brave play, as usually carries weakness property, but maybe not so much in this format.
Ooh, as it does not, as we do get the confirmation, but the Taunt comes out thanks to that pranks the priority, goes into the Amoongus, stops it from going for Spore, but guess what? It goes for Sludge Bomb, and it picks up a poison onto the Tornadus, as the Moltres will now be targeting down the Comfey with an Air Slash, nearly dealing half HP's worth of damage onto the Comfey, and does reveal the Life Orb.
Yeah, and we were saying that that's a pretty passive lead from Diogo's side of the field, but they've done more damage to Kobe's side of the field, especially with that poison as well. It doesn't need the Spore, even if it gets taunted. The poison is going to rack up on that Tornadus. At least it can still attack, but is going to be taking that passive damage. Probably going to be in range of a Draining Kiss and a Sludge Bomb double up if that is what Diogo wants to go for. Maybe even the Moltres would be as well.
As we are to be seeing the Draining Kiss once again coming out from the Comfey, it will actually be proccing that Berserk ability, which will be giving the Moltres a plus one of special attack. But it's quite interesting to see the amount of damage that Comfey is dealing. Not what you would expect, as the Sludge Bomb just misses out from picking up a KO there, allowing the Moltres to move and go for the Air Slash into the Comfey, but it KOs itself due to the Life Orb recoil as the Tornadus tries to go for Air Slash into the Amoongus' slot, and we do actually see the reveal of a Cobra Berry halving the damage output of that Flying-type move.
Taking almost no damage there at all, and the poison is still going to be racking up there. And we saw that Moltres was just in range of the double up, factoring in its own Life Orb recoil as well. So the Tornadus is still going to be pretty threatened here as well. At least Solgaleo is what a Pokemon you want to be facing down the Comfey and the Amoongus, because it is going to be taunted as well, and it's going to be that shiny Solgaleo as well. They're going to be nice and red there, so it's still going to be threatening a lot of damage with the Solgaleo at this point. You've still got one more turn of the Taunt on the Amoongus. You don't need to be concerned about any of the moves coming out from the Amoongus if you are the Solgaleo. If Sludge Bomb is the only offensive move that Amoongus has, it's going to be completely useless against this Solgaleo here. Some Amoongus do opt to carry a coverage move, something like Grass Knot or maybe even Foul Play, to be able to do some damage to the Steel types, but yeah, Solgaleo, even though it is in the Trick Room at this point, is still looking in a very nice position, and the Tornadus is going to be starting to rack up that damage with the poison. At least the Cobra Berry's gone on the Amoongus now, so if you do follow up with another Air Slash, it's going to be doing a lot more damage.
Oh, Drain Kiss goes into the Tornadus slot as the damage is accumulating and picking up thanks to that poison that it was able to land from the Amoongus Sludge Bomb. Taunt actually comes out, goes into the Comfey slot, wasn't trying to make sure that it cannot set up Trick Room again, but guess what? Mental Herb is revealed. It shakes off the Taunt as the Sludge Bomb comes out from the Amoongus, picks up a KO onto that Tornadus, and the Solgaleo goes for Rock Slide there. Actually misses on the Comfey, does deal a bit of chip damage onto the Amoongus, but not able to do that much in that situation.
I'm taking back the passive lead completely. The Comfey and the Amoongus has picked up two knockouts here on a Tornadus and a Moltres. So yeah, I take that back completely. And now the Rillaboom is going to come in here. It's going to threaten some good damage into the Comfey with the Grassy Glide at least. And then the Solgaleo will probably be able to follow up into the Amoongus with an attack of its own. But yeah, it's still an incredibly awkward position for Kobe here. So yeah, they pretty much managed to stall out the Trick Room at this point, but then you've got that Evelthal almost certainly waiting in the back, and Evelthal is going to be such a strong Pokemon against the Solgaleo and the Rillaboom.
Exactly, as the Solgaleo is going to go for the Protect, and the Comfey goes for the Floral Healing. It's going to be able to capitalize off the grass terrain being on the field. And of course, because it does have an increased amount of HP that it can recover, maybe not that applicable to that scenario, as the Grassy Glide does come out from the Rillaboom, picks up a KO onto the Comfey, and the Spore is met with the Protect from the Solgaleo's side of the field, as Trick Room is now over, Jamie.
Yeah, managed to stall out the Trick Room. So if there's something like the Torkoal waiting in the back, that would be very strong against the Rillaboom and the Solgaleo, but wouldn't have its speed advantage anymore. Instead, it's just going to be Evelthal, and I'm really struggling to see a way that Kobe breaks through this Evelthal at this point. The Amoongus is no longer taunted, so you almost certainly can't knock out the Amoongus. Even if you're carrying something like Psychic Fangs, maybe that would be enough, or the Zen Headbutts, to be able to knock out the Amoongus, but even then, the Evelthal can just follow up with any of the dark moves it's going to be carrying. It does have a plethora of dark choices available for it to be able to attack the Solgaleo, and really, Evelthal can just ignore a Rillaboom completely, and it is going to be foul play as the move of choice just picks up a clean knockout on Solgaleo.
Oh my lord. Solgaleo goes absolutely skyrocket out of game one as knockoff comes out from the Rillaboom, maybe wanting to try to make sure and scout out the item choice there, as we do see it reveals that Assault Vest, and Spore wanting to make sure it targets down the Solgaleo just in case it somehow survives.
Yeah, it makes sense to go for the knockoff into the Evelthal. You want to get as much information as you can going into the game too, so you're almost certainly not going to be able to break through this Evelthal. It's able to knock out the Rillaboom in two foul plays here. And so, yeah, like the Amoongus probably going to be able to pick up the knockout here with just the Sludge Bomb here. So it looks like the Comfey and the Amoongus did, what, 2.5 damage of the opposing Pokemon? So, yeah, that's... Yeah, we've got to just eat our words there completely with the passivity of that lead. And yeah, that was just a crazy showing of two just such supportive Pokemon.
I'm sorry. I think we've now established the new meta, ladies and gents. Offensive prowess of Comfey and Amoongus in that scenario. And I mean, honestly, like you said, very impressive play from having just Amoongus and Comfey slow everything down quite literally with Trick Room, but then also just get rid of the Pokemon over on the Kobe side slowly yet surely, to the point where Evelthal comes in outside of Trick Room and just outspeeds, picks up raw KOs with those foul plays. I'm sorry, I feel like that must be a Dark type boosted. Oh no, it's not actually, it's Assault Vest, but that foul play just paying dividends as to why it is so good on an Evelthal when you do have that Dark Aura ability in play.
Yeah, Dark Aura, a very, very strong ability, effectively giving it a life orb boost to any of its Dark type moves, so going to be really strong there. And it seemed like the Comfey and Amoongus were even teched out perfectly against the opposing Pokemon that Kobe brought with that Mental Herb, putting a stop to that taunt from the Tornadus, and the Kobe Berry as well, facing down the Tornadus. So
yeah,
Comfey and Amoongus were pretty much perfectly matched into that Tornadus, even though you wouldn't expect them to be. So yeah, this is going to have to be going back to the drawing board for Kobe's side of the field here. You do need to, I can't believe I'm saying this, you do need to deal with those Comfey and Amoongus a bit quicker than you did, so rather than just leave them on the field. So it's going to have to be Kobe's game to adjust here.
It really, really will have to be. Kobe can still bring this back and try to force a game three, but then again, Diogo can go ahead and just force that 2-0 win. Let's see the leads as, yes, Jamie, it is that very deadly combination of Amoongus and Comfey versus a changeup over on Kobe's side, being the Solgaleo and the Raikou double shinies there as well.
Yeah, so a little bit of a switch up with the Raikou there. I think that's quite a nice adjustment. You do have potential to go for something like a Bulldoze into the Solgaleo. That is something we saw a lot with the legendary dogs going for the Bulldoze into the Solgaleo to activate a weakness policy if that's what they're having access to. And that looks like what we're seeing here. The Bulldoze going into the Solgaleo, almost certainly activating that weakness policy as we do see on that Solgaleo. That's going to be enough to almost certainly pick up a knockout on this Amoongus,
as it will be dropping the speeds of all Pokemon except that Solgaleo, of course, as the Solgaleo is going to be going for the Sunsteel Strike right now. Highly threatening, so much damage. Let's see and find out if it is indeed. Whoa! There it goes. Amoongus is out of game two, ladies and gents, officially, as Comfy, though, is going to be able to go ahead and get that trick room set up.
But you don't have the Amoongus now threatening those spores anymore. And we saw that Evolful outsped the Solgaleo here, so it does have to be Torkoal coming in to threaten down that Solgaleo. And now you have to wonder if that Solgaleo does have access to White Guards. You do have to be a little bit scared of that if you are the Torkoal player. Maybe even just going for a single target fire move into the Solgaleo at this point, if you do have access to that. Because the Raikou is not going to be able to threaten the Torkoal too much. A Thunderbolt would hurt. But that would probably be the worst case that it could do. It could go for something like a Snarl to reduce the damage output, but then that's not really putting any damage onto the board, onto Diogo's side of the field.
It really isn't, as Solgaleo is actually going to just opt to go for that Protect. It does not want to be subject to any sort of Eruption or Heatwave play over from that Torkoal side. Draining Kiss will be able to recover a bit of HP's worth for Sacrifice of Raikou's HP on the other side of the field, as Eruption is coming out from the Torkoal and is picking up a very clean KO onto that Raikou. That could even potentially, I'm not sure if the Raikou is Assault Fest there, because they do tend to be, but my word, that was so much damage as we see the Mian Shao coming in.
It would have definitely been able to survive if it was Assault Vest, so almost certainly not going to be there. Unless that may be a Choice Specs Torkoal, potentially, but even still, that's not fearing the White Guard there coming out from the Solgaleo. But you do need to be concerned about the White Guard, at least from the Mind Shao now, because that's a very commonly run with White Guards. You've got to be concerned about the Fake Out as well, putting a stop to the Torkoal this turn. You can go for the Fake Out into the Torkoal, the Sunsteel Strike into the Comfey. You know that's not carrying a Focus Sash. That would be a KO at that point. And then you'd be able to hopefully be able to get a Sunsteel Strike into the available outside of Trick Room before that Foul Play. But Torkoal is just going to be protecting itself here.
Protecting itself here, being very well aware of the situation. That Draining Kiss dealing so much damage onto the Mian Shao. Mian Shao, due to the interaction of the abilities there of Triage from Comfey, is going to be moving second with its Fake Out into the Protect there. And the Solgaleo actually opting to go for Rock Slide instead of maybe trying to pick up a KO onto the Comfey if it could. And it does even land a critical hit there.
Yeah, so doing some nice damage to the Comfey. It doesn't allow a switch into the available at least, so no potential Sucker Punches coming out as well. So now you do definitely need to be concerned about this White Guard if you are on Duro's side of the field with the Torkoal. The Draining Kiss is actually going to be able to knock out the Mind Shao here before any potential White Guards can come out, so really showing off the triage there. The same priority speed tiers of White Guard and Draining Kiss, but Comfey is slower in the Trick Room, so able to put a stop to that White Guard. Didn't even matter, the Torkoal went for Flamethrower.
It went for Flamethrower. Lord, I cannot believe the amount of work that this Comfey has put in to this set, as the Flamethrower just absolutely knocks out that Solgaleo and just forces the Moltres to remain on its own. That triage ability from the Comfey just proving why it is so good to have all, HP giving moves from a Comfey side, a plus three booster.
And the crucial part of the triage is allowing it to have such increased priority with the Draining Kiss, being able to bypass things like Fake Outs. As we saw, it did out-prioritize the Fake Out from the Mind Shout. It out-prioritized the White Guards that we did get a sneak peek that was going to be coming out as well. And yeah, that's not going to be a real strong way of breaking through this Moltres. Even the Comfey itself probably could 1v1 this Moltres at this point, especially because its Life Orb will be chipping itself away with the Fiery Wrath as well. Looks like the Comfey probably going to be wanting to get that Trick Room up for the Torkoal once again, and then it can just start spamming the Eruptions at full HP because it did protect itself this turn. And yeah, that's what we're seeing here. So Moltres is not going to be an Avelful. It's not going to be doing some strong Shocker Punches into this Torkoal. You're going to be able to get some strong Eruptions. Even though the Sun's disappeared, it's still going to be single target Eruption. It's still going to be doing a lot of damage. And then the Comfey's just following up with Draining Kisses. And that's not even concerned about the Avelful that's waiting in the back. Avelful's going to be able to 1v1 a Moltres easily. So you've still got to break through these Comfey and Torkoal first and then deal with the Avelful somehow. And I'm not sure that the Moltres is able to do it here.
I don't think so either. I think this is a horrible matchup for Kobe in this set, to be honest, as we do see the Eruption single target there, even without the Sun, is more than enough to pick up a KO there. Diogo absolutely romping their way through this set. 2-0 win right there, and honestly, I do have to say kudos for Diogo for being able to just prep very well, because it just seems like I'm not sure. That just, it was such a bad matchup for Toby, to be honest, because there was not much they could do, quite literally, because of all the checks that Diogo had on their side of the field. I'm not sure if there was any sort of research going into each player, because obviously this is a team tournament. Let's not forget that. You do have time up until your match to try to do any research you can to find information on them. But my word, that was just an absolute rock-sliding performance from Toby there. Sorry, from Diogo.
Yeah, it seemed like that that Diogo's side was pretty much teched out perfectly. We saw the mental herb putting a stop to the taunt. We saw the Torko just being able to one shot that Solgaleo. Pretty much pinned the Solgaleo in Trick Room. Torko was able to knock it out in one shot. Outside of Trick Room, Velt was able to knock it out in one shot. And then the Comfy was just like running rampant. Even against the Solgaleo, Comfy was putting in so much work, being able to out-prioritize the Mind Shell completely with the fake outs and the wide guard. So yeah, really, really solid bring from Diogo's side of the field, and really showed with that performance.
It really did, and Portugal is able to now, at least as the scores do currently remain, bring it back 2-2 between Israel and Portugal. Of course, all other matches that have not been submitted yet, those results, that is, will be conducted over the weekend, Saturday and Sunday. So please, if you are very interested in seeing the results of all of these very great matches between all these great countries, go ahead and use the Victory Roads worldcupvgc.com website, where you will be able to see all the results as soon as they are submitted onto the website.
Yeah, so some really, really strong games coming out for today, and we do have a few more tomorrow and the next day on Saturday and Sunday. So that is going to be it for us for today, but please come back this weekend to catch some more great matches from this World Cup.
Thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in, and we will be catching you very soon, or should I say tomorrow. Have a lovely night, and we'll catch you tomorrow.